guys, Dexic Pro with a new one. In this demonstration, I'm gonna be teaching you how to jailbreak PlayStation 4 system software version 9 with the latest method that just published the other day. To proceed, we gotta download a couple of files that I also put the links in description for you guys to download as well. First off, go to rufus.ie and download Rufus USB Stick Boot Creator. Then we need to download the second file, which is the exploit file, from here. And eventually, download the official PS4 system software version 9. Great. Done with the downloading stuff, so let's get back to the computer. It's time to transfer firmware version 9 to USB stick to upgrade my PlayStation 4 from 5.05 to 9. Plug the USB stick to computer, format it with the exFAT file system. Rename the downloaded firmware to PS4 updates, all in capital, then copy-paste it into the USB stick. Finished. Cool. Unplug and plug it back to the PS4 USB port. Go to Settings, System Software Update. As you can see, PS4 detected the firmware version in the USB stick we just copied, which is version 9. Next. And update. Then PS4 starts to copy the firmware from the USB into the hard disk drive and prep it for installation. It restarts and goes into recovery mode to proceed the updating task. So wait till it's finished. Okay, updating is finished. So far, so good. Let me check the version by going to Settings, System, System Information. And here it is, version 9. Awesome. Next step, which is very important, is to disable auto download to prevent PS4 from updating to the latest version. So go to Automatic Downloads and uncheck all of these boxes. Alrighty, next step is deleting the contents of the web browser. Go to Dashboard and open up the web browser. Push the Option button on controller to get the menu. Browsing History, Options, Clear Browsing History, OK. Settings, Delete Cookies, Clear Website Data, and OK. You might ask, why did I do this, right? Because we want to cache the new host on the browser, so the old one must be wiped out in order to work without any troubles. Okay, I'm done with the internet browser. Great. Time to connect to the internet by going to the Settings, Network, and I go for my Wi-Fi. Now I want to go on the Custom instead because I want to set the DNS here. Now it's scanning the network. Let me put my Wi-Fi user and pass. Alrighty. IP settings, automatic. DHCP, also automatic. DNS, here it is, guys. Go on manual instead and set this to this IP address, 192.241.221.79. Done. And next. MTU, automatic. Proxy, don't use. So let's test the internet connection. Successful. Great. Next step is prepping bootable USB exploit by getting back to computer. Connect USB stick to computer. Open up Rufus. Make sure the USB stick is detected in device list here. From boot selection, click on select and find the exploit file we already downloaded, then open it. Click on start and that's it, ready to use. Unplug it, but don't plug it back into your PS4, guys. It's not the time yet, okay? Alright, back to the PS4. As you can recall, we already connected PS4 to the internet, set a DNS, and we clear all the caches in browser, right? Good. Now we go to settings and open up user's guide. It automatically opens up the host from the DNS IP address we already set, then starts to cache the theme. You should wait till it's finished. Alright, open PS4 9. Click on cache all to save it for later offline usage. Click on Gold Hand Payload to inject. Just wait a little bit to get the message. Okay, here's the message. Now connect the USB stick to PS4, but don't hit on OK yet, guys. It's soon. Let the unsupported file system pop-up appears, okay? Here's the message. Now hit on OK. And that's it. My PS4 is fully and successfully jailbroken now. Tremendous. Okay, back to the dashboard. Go to Settings, and here is Gold Hand 2, as you can see on the top, which represents jailbreaking sign. And as you can see, we got FTP, bin loader, and package installer here as well. Awesome. Okay, as you know, every time that you restart or power off the PS4, you need to jailbreak it again, right? In order to avoid confusion, let's restart the PS4 and jailbreak it back for the second time, making sure everything works like a charm. So I restart. Okay guys, I'm back again. So go to settings, the network, and make sure that the PS4 is not connected to the internet because we already cached the exploit host. Open up the user's guide. Hit on gold hand. Plug the USB stick again and wait for unsupported file system message. Okay, here's the message. Now hit on OK. And I'm all set. Tremendous. And that's the end of this video tutorial. Thank you for watching and have a good one. Subscribe to DexTech Pro YouTube channel.